Welcome to He Speaks with Kate. I am your host, Kate Law. And today is about forgiveness. And I'm going to be honest with you. I had to do this one again because I'm lazy. And the first one was a little choppy and I was looking at my notes and it was okay. But Omar, my producer, good man that he is from Red Sky Recordings, said, you know, Kate, you know, do you want to do it again? It's just like, I will, because I left out something kind of important. And I'm going to start, I'm holding a rock, by the way. And this rock says, I'm sorry on it. And there's a little story behind this one is the fact that I was at my prayer group the other day on Mondays. It's Mothers in Prayer. And I'd gotten these rocks and they're cool. You know, those sandblasted ones. It says believe and love and wisdom. And I found this one saying, I'm sorry. And it's like, ooh, I'm going to give that one away. Anyway, I put them in a bag and I took them to my prayer group. And I said to the ladies, I said, I've prayed over this bag. Now put your hand in here and pick one. And I'm hoping this is silly, but this is how I roll. I was really hoping that to get rid of this rock. And the leader of the group picked one out and I saw that she'd gotten wisdom. Oh, I love that one. And then my other gal, she reached in the bag and she got one that said love. Oh, I love that one. Well, guess which one was left for me? I'm sorry. And so this show is on forgiveness. And it just so happened, this is what the Lord does with me. He used to do it when I taught Sunday school. I'd read a lesson. I'm the whole time thinking, what do you want for these kids? And I'll do my reading. And always he'd flatten me out, make sure I got that lesson first through circumstances, and then I'd share it with the kids. Well, he's done it this week with me because this is on forgiveness. And what do you think happened this week, dear one? Of course, I had not one, not two times, three times where I literally had to say, please forgive me. I've blown it again and again. My teenage son, oh, kudos to him. Compliments to Jordan. He is a teenager. And all that encompasses, knows everything, right? On his phone, always doesn't have any time for chores, dishes, or cleaning because he's always doing homework. Then you check his battery level and you see that he's been on Snapchat and he's been on Instagram and he's been on YouTube. You're not fooling me. I took his phone away for a week. High school student. Wow. But, you know, Kate, you could do that. You know, you can do that, but it's how I did it. I yelled at him and I wasn't kind. And so I had to apologize. Still didn't get his phone back, but I did have to apologize because I know better. I didn't have to belittle him or be disrespectful to him. Anyway, I had to get that off my chest. We're going to go into the story about a crazy story, but this really did happen. The background is my childhood upbringing with a single mom, alcoholic father that had left. My mom did get remarried. Three other children joined us, the family. We were the Brady Bunch in the 70s, but my real sister, Judy, and I, we just weren't that close. And then even in adulthood, just my first divorce, things got nasty. She was telling me, you know, what I should do or could do. And, you know, we just had differences. And she literally didn't talk to me for, I don't know, 6 years. And I mean, we're talking no birthday cards, no, wouldn't return emails or texts. And it was a very painful time in my life. And I actually got to this point where I numbed it with the fact that that's okay. I don't, you know, there's plenty of people that don't get along with their siblings. And I have a great relationship with my stepsister, Kim. We adore each other. I'm very close to her. But my real sister, just, we weren't. And I prayed. I said, Lord, I would really like that to be restored. But years went by and another year went by. And it wasn't until, like I said, my husband died. No funeral. I mean, no support, no nothing. And I got this feeling that I was supposed to go down to Rick Warren's church in Lake Forest, California. He's got a beautiful church, Saddleback. And it was kind of strange because I was a Sunday school teacher teaching at my church, but this particular Sunday, I was off. It wasn't my turn. And I said to my children, I really think we're supposed to pile in the van and head on down to this church and just be obedient. And my son was 6, my other son was 13, and my daughter was 15. But Mom, you know, where is it? You know, how far? I don't know when it starts. We're going. So we actually pull into the parking lot. Turns out that the service is going to start in about 15 minutes. I was kind of excited because I just knew God was up to something. Rick Warren wasn't speaking that morning, but another pastor was. And the title was very interesting. It was, if you had 30 days to live, if you knew you were only going to live for 30 days, how would you live your life? Is there anybody that you need to get right with? And I'm like, you know, I'm thinking to myself, I'm good, you know, and I look at my daughter like, are you all right? And she goes, Mom, what about Aunt Judy? And it's like, oh, that's right. The pastor had actually said, if you're wearing jewelry or a bracelet or a watch or a ring, put it on the opposite hand and it'll feel uncomfortable and you go get right with anyone that you need to do that with. And so as we're leaving, I got the feeling that we were supposed to literally get in the car and now drive another hour, hour and a half in the opposite direction to go get right with my sister. And unannounced, didn't call, and we show up and she's not there. And I was praying, I was going, you know something, you guys, I mean, this is you're confiding with your kids. I am so uncomfortable right now. My heart is pounding and I just was writing a note. And just then she drove up and it's like, oh, this could be really ugly. I don't know if this was such a great idea. I love my sister, but she's kind of like me. We're both outspoken, kind of explosive. And she's beautiful and fun loving, but I mean, you just don't know. Anyway, I saw her and I just literally opened up the door and I was just bawling and I just hugged her and said, oh, Jenny, I just came from church and the sermon was on if you had 30 days to live. I mean, how, and I don't like what's happening between us and I love you. I love you. And she just, you know, she hugged me and I want to let you know that that was the beginning of restoration for our relationship. Well, as I had promised at the beginning of the show, I said I was going to give some techniques about what I've learned about forgiveness. I highly recommend if you have children, nieces or nephews or people that, you know, especially the young people, young children need to learn this at an early age. And we're not actually saying the words, I'm sorry. These words are pretty darn cheap. You need to look that person in the eye and say, please forgive me. I said this hurtful word to you. And is there anything that I need to do to make up for it? And that other person then has the power to say, yeah, you really did tick me off. And you listen. You listen without saying anything. And then what you're supposed to do afterwards is you reconcile. You hug or you shake hands and it is done. You don't bring it up again, right? You don't, husband and wives, I'm talking to you. Remember 6 years ago when you don't do that. It is gone. Don't go fishing. It's gone. Now, there's another technique that I learned from Dr. Charles Stanley, a Baptist minister. He's got a wonderful ministry called intouchministries.org. He's been ministering for over 50 years. I listen to him every single day. In fact, I even went on a cruise to Alaska with him. He didn't make it. His son, Andy Stanley, did, but it was fantastic. This is what you do. You've got a chair. Remember, I told you this is for the people that are either not in your life, they're in another state, or they've passed, and you can't say you're sorry to them. So there's another chair that's empty that you put across from you. And you just visualize and you talk to them. I've done this a couple times. I did it with my dad because he died when I was in my 20s. And I was pissed. I mean, I looked at that chair and I just got it out. I said, you know, I'm so mad you chose alcohol over your wife and your kids. And, you know, we've got so much pain and neglect and so much hurt that has just lasted years and years. I am so mad. I got it out, and then I looked at that chair, visualizing my dad, and I just said, I thank you for the good things that you gave me, the genes. I've got German, English, Irish. I've got my brain. I've got my work ethic from him. I thanked him for that, and I choose to forgive you. I actually separated the man from what he did, the sin, and I let it go. And I experienced some freedom from that day on. And you can do the same. There's a little caveat here I need to say. If you've forgiven somebody, that doesn't mean someone that has abused you, that doesn't mean you hang out with them if they're not safe. You can forgive somebody, but do it with healthy boundaries. That is what I wanted to say. The litmus test is, of course, when you bring up this person's name, you don't have that pain in your heart. You don't want to hide. You don't want to go in the other aisle. You want to see them. You can you've let go. You are free. And you remember the old saying, everyone kind of knows this, but it is so true. You might say, Kate, you know, I'm too old to go do this stuff. I'm not going to start forgiving my parents now. Unforgiveness is like drinking poison and waiting for the other person to die. It's only hurting you. So there's also another little prayer that you can pray. Say, Kate, I'm not willing to do that. I say, well, how about we say a prayer that the Lord will help you to be willing to be willing? Isn't that a good start? And I hope you can do that today. I hope this has been helpful. You have to do it more than once. There's also counseling. I highly recommend Celebrate Recovery. It's free. Get yourself a sponsor. Have somebody else come in with them, male or female, and just say, hey, I got to do this. I just want accountability partner. I've even done this one. I love this. I write a lot, so I journal a lot. I'll take that piece of paper, and I write all that stuff that's in my heart, and I light a match to it over the sink, and I burn it, and it's gone. It's out of my heart. It's out of my life, and you are free. That's it. Thank you. Thank you for tuning in to He Speaks with Kate. Thank you, Omar Duenas, RedSkyRecordings.com in beautiful Santa Ana, California. We do have an email now that you can get a hold of us, and it's HeSpeaksWithKate@gmail.com. What can I say besides slow down? We'll all slow down. He speaks to us every single day. Bye-bye.